My connection with the SIA is, I can't hide it, there aren't many generics out there, so I come from the family of Charlton and generics. I've grown up in the industry. I've discussed around the kitchen table, I think, every night for my whole life, the ins and outs of electrifiers, gas fires, and more recently, stoves. So I'm as passionate as some of you are about the industry. I'd like to see it succeed. I think it's a wonderful industry because it's very British. You know, what you manufacture is almost always done in rural areas that desperately need jobs, places like where I grew up in Shropshire, but areas, the Isle of Wight, Suffolk, you know, many parts of the UK represented here today. You're a great British product, which we'd love to see more exports of, but what we want to do above all, and I think what today is about celebrating, is the fact that the industry is playing its part in the challenge of, or meeting the challenge of air pollution, and that the eco design that we're going to hear about later on is a major contribution to that. And we want to see the government responding to that, appreciating the hard work that you're doing as an industry and that the SIA is doing, and the role that you're going to play in making sure that's respected, and that you're not inadvertently caught by regulations that are certainly not meant to impact industry that's putting so much effort into getting this right and to playing its part in ensuring that our towns and cities have the air quality that we all want to see them, as well as a great British industry that produces something that all of us who've lived in the countryside and love rural life know is an absolutely integral part of being British and living in the countryside. So thank you for coming here today. It's my pleasure to introduce Simon Hoare, who is a Member of Parliament and is the Parliamentary Private Secretary to Therese Coffey, who sadly couldn't be with us today. But Simon is going to say a few words on her behalf. So if we could all welcome Simon to today's event.
Well, Robert, thank you very much indeed for that introduction. And I think, first of all, you are absolutely right to highlight the very important and very good news story that the stove sector represents, as you say, not just for UK manufacturing, but also in our rural communities, which certainly I represent as the Member of Parliament for North Dorset. I never think a farmhouse or a cottage or a barn conversion is replete without three things: an Arga, smelly Labrador, and a woodburning stew. So, usually something to drink while sitting alongside it, but that's quite that's by the by. I'm obviously not Therese Coffey, for those of you who didn't go to Specsavers this morning. She sends you her very good wishes and wishes good success for this afternoon. She is in one of those dwindling events in a minister's diary at a European Council this afternoon. We're on countdown for how often they will have to be going off to that, so she apologises that she is not here. I'd like to thank Robert and indeed Neil for hosting this event, and also the Alliance for making your new design and announcing it this afternoon. Now, as we all know, and may I just say these are not my words, these are written by DEFRA. I hope that they make some sense, but we will see. But as we all know, and I certainly have one, wood-burning stoves are growing in popularity and provide an excellent and alternative way to heat our homes in an environmentally sustainable and sensitive way. But there's always two sides, isn't there, to every coin. And the government is firmly committed to working as hard as it possibly can with industry, with manufacturers, and with others in order to improve air quality right the way across the country. And I think it's been interesting, I say this, I'll go off brief, don't tell the officials, it's been quite interesting that I clearly said, you know, stoves are a hallmark of barn conversions in farmhouses, but the sort of trendy loft conversions of Islington and elsewhere are all now looking to have wood-burning stoves in areas very often where air quality isn't particularly good. So this is not by necessity a rural air quality issue. The impacts on vehicle emissions are already widely discussed and understood. As you know, this is not the only source of air pollution, and we also need to think about other everyday activities, including how we heat our homes and the impact that that process has. Burning fuels such as wood and coal generate fine particles of soot and dust, which we can get into the lungs and blood and be transported around the body. I mean, I think we're all going to be putting our fires out this evening, but there we are. And we know that we can't stop heating our homes, well, stating the blindingly obvious, isn't it? But there's much we can do to ensure that we all make informed decisions on purchasing the most efficient stoves and fuel. and maintaining regular servicing so that people can warm their homes as cleanly and as safely as possible. Now, your new EcoDesign Ready brand is a great example of industry taking the lead to promote the benefits of more efficient and cleaner technologies and bringing them to the market. These appliances will meet, as you know, the fundamental requirements of the new EcoDesign Directive that will start in 2020 for solid fuel burners and 2022 for solid fuel local space heaters. So you're well ahead of the curve. And the EcoDesign Ready brand will help people easily identify. I think it's all about helping the consumer make those informed decisions and choices. Will help people easily identify those appliances that meet the most important emission standards needed to comply with the directive. And as highlighted in the paperwork that we had inviting us today to launch Ready Stoves, estimated that to produce 90% fewer emissions than an open fire, these stoves are producing 90% fewer emissions than an open fire, and 84% less than a stove of just 10 years ago, which just goes to show the huge progress which has been made. Retailers and those installing stoves, I happen to be at a point-to-point in my constituency on Sunday talking to a company from Wimborne who do just that, three or four young men who just get how important the stove sector is and they're making their living out of that in a rural area, have a responsibility to make sure their customers understand what they can and cannot burn in a stove and how to use them properly. This makes sure that stoves are running in the most efficient and cost-effective way and that they are not creating unnecessary smoke and air pollution. And you may have seen a few weeks ago we had started to have a bit of a campaign war against orange netted, poorly seasoned garage forecourt wood. Hopefully they will go down in levels of popularity as much as sort of garage flowers will do on Mother's Day or wedding anniversaries. It is important that stove owners know that dry wood burns better and is therefore better value for their money. But it is also important to understand that dry wood reduces emissions of smoke and soot, those things which cause air pollution and the health problems that go with it, whilst wet wood or general household waste generate far more dangerous particulate matter pollution. Properly seasoned and dried wood can reduce levels of pollution from a home stove by up to 50%. Finally, it is important that stoves are installed safely and correctly and then used and maintained properly to protect our health and environment. And we were talking just before the session started, the one thing that always makes my blood boil and toes curl is when you flick through sort of Country Life or Country Living magazine, those wonderful scenes, those rural idylls of a blazing wood burner surrounded by logs. I mean, the fire insurance people must go absolutely mad because we tried it once and I can tell you it doesn't work. Luckily, my fire alarm went off a little sooner than the rest of the wood did. Buying new clean stoves, burning seasoned wood and regular servicing will help to cut air pollution and produce more heat from less fuel. And therefore, DEFRA, the Minister and I welcome the proactive approach taken by HETAS and the Stove Industry Alliance and others in the industry to ensure that innovation and technology sit alongside advice on how to use modern stoves cleanly. The government's ambition is that ours will be the first generation to leave the natural environment in a better state than we found it. It's there, it's in black and white, it's in the Conservative Party manifesto for the 2015 election. And I know that we politicians are not necessarily always held as those who then publish manifestos and then actually stick to them. But certainly working in the department since last summer, it is, I think, the firmest commitment which the DEFRA ministerial team hang on to as the most important contribution that we can make to the environment. Part of that is, of course, improving the UK's air quality and cutting harmful emissions. We all have a role to play to help consumers understand how to make their stoves burn clearly, and all of you here today have an interest in the stove and fuel industry. And I would like to close by asking that you receive this message positively and help us all to work together to make a positive difference for UK PLC, both in terms of our business community, but also in terms of our environmental community as well. Thank you.
My name is Dennis Milligan. I'm Head of Communications with the Stove Industry Alliance. The purpose of the Stove Industry Alliance is to educate and promote the benefits of burning wood in an efficient plant, both to the environment and obviously to the household. I want to give you a little presentation, which I'll be as quick as I can on, just take you through what EcoDesign Ready Stoves are. And I've called this presentation The Stoves of Tomorrow Are Here Today, because the stoves that we're releasing today aren't due, as been said, until 2022 in terms of regulation. But we are so interested in the environment, obviously we want to release them early. That's nearly 5 years early, in fact. That's what we're doing. So we believe that there are four main topics that need to be covered when you're looking at heating a house, and that is carbon reduction, energy efficiency, sustainability, and indeed air quality. And that's the four things I'm going to try and run through today as I talk to you. In terms of carbon reduction, the thing is that logs of all the biomass fuels, pellets and so forth, basically give you the least amount of carbon emissions whenever they're burnt, and significantly less than they do with oil or gas. We have given model which shows that by 2020 we actually can produce, I think, 20% of their carbon reduction target. I'm out of space now. The reason the stoves are able to produce so little emissions is because they're actually designed to burn cleanly and to burn efficiently. Here, basically, wood burning can be regarded as carbon neutral, and that is if you take the life cycle of wood from the planting of the trees through to its burning. Basically, the wood that's, the carbon is given off when the wood is burnt is actually reabsorbed in the trees that are planted. And here I'm showing you the carbon factors in grams per kilowatt hour that are from the BAE's SAP program, which is used to calculate the carbon reduction or the carbon produced by a house. And you can see logs are by far the lowest contributor in that. And as I managed to say at a turn, what we've shown BAE's is that wood burning stoves can account for 10%, not the 20% that I stepped at earlier, in terms of the carbon reduction targets for 2020. In terms of energy efficiency, the EcoDesign Ready stoves that we're releasing would be grouped as an A plus in terms of the chart of energy efficiency, and that's with an efficiency of about 80%, compared to an open fire, which would be a G on 30%. And a stove of 10 years ago would have been on 65%. So you can see the progression that we've made in terms of efficiency over the years. When it comes to sustainability, There's a misconception that in order to produce logs, you have to cut the woodlands down. In actual fact, logs come from the thinning of the woodlands. And what we're finding, and what you'll find, is that for the health of a woodland, you need to thin it. And so really, taking the logs out of the forest is actually part of maintaining that forest and keeping it healthy. And indeed, if a branch falls to the ground, what actually happens is that the emissions that are given off by that branch naturally actually give off more emissions than they would if they were burnt in a stove. And we're finding that 50% of the woodlands in the UK are basically thinned, so there's another 50% that aren't currently managed. So the availability of wood and sustainability, therefore, for the years to come is really quite strong. And obviously, the more trees we plant, obviously, the better. There is a fashion element to wood-burning stoves, so they're often regarded as a fashion fad, and certainly there is a fashion element. People buy them to fit in with their furniture of their room. Also, it's a lifestyle choice that people like to interact with the fire. But again, we'd like to say that wood-burning stoves are actually a serious form of heating. They are, for many people, on and off the gas grid, a way of heating their houses. And basically, for many people, it is the low-carbon heating choice that they can make. And that's done without RHI. There's been absolutely no financial support given to the development of stove sales over the last 10 years, and yet they've grown significantly year on year. In 2015, DEC produced a survey of how people use wood, and what came out of that was that wood-burning stoves were used on an average of 27 hours per week, compared to 26 hours for other biomass appliances. And the point we're taking from that is that you can see that they're not just something that people are burning at weekends. They're actually using them seriously throughout the week to heat their houses. And as again was said earlier, there is a significant correlation between the price of oil and gas and the sales of stoves. When oil prices go up, so do stove sales. When oil prices go down, stove sales go down. It's very much linked to the price of heating. And for many people, when oil is expensive, heating a house with a wood-burning stove is seen as the cheaper alternative, the cheaper way to heat their houses. Again, as we said earlier, the EcoDesign legislation is the European-wide legislation designed to reduce the emissions from stoves. It's supported by DEFRA, as you've heard today, and we believe it will significantly reduce the emissions that are coming out from a stove, as indeed you'll see from this graph. So these graphs are taken from research that was done on our behalf by Kiva Gaswa, totally independent of ourselves. And you can see that the red line in each graph represents the EcoDesign limit. So basically in 2022, you've got to be below the red line. So you can see from particulates to gaseous carbon compounds through to CO and NOx, that you have this significant drop in emissions with EcoDesign stoves. And that really is a point that we're trying to make today, is that once we introduce EcoDesign stoves, you can see a immediate drop off in emissions from the stove. So we're calling them EcoDesign Ready because the legislation for EcoDesign doesn't come in until 2022. But the EcoDesign Ready stoves that we're launching today will meet the emissions in 2022. And the point we're making very strongly is those stoves are available today rather than having to wait until 2022. The main members of the SIA are giving the commitment that any new models that they develop from here on in will meet the EcoDesign criteria, and that by 2020 the SIA main manufacturers will only produce stoves that meet the emission criteria 2 years ahead of its required implementation date. So again, that's just giving you the commitment that we're wanting to make towards the environment, towards clean air. Now moving into particulates in general, what we're trying to say is research done by King's College has shown that in winter time, the PM emissions from wood would peak at about 10% in London. But the same survey I referred to earlier from DEC, looking at the uses of wood, showed that 70% of the wood burnt in London actually is from open fires. So if you were to replace those open fires by EcoDesign Ready stoves, you could see we would reduce the amount of PM coming out by 80%. And compared to a stove of 10 years, we would reduce it by 90%, and by a stove of 10 years ago, 80%. So you can see a significant reduction. And again, you know, we all want to reduce PM emissions. And again, I think the big problem for London is a lot of it's coming from open fires, which really we can show the improvement on. And this is the graph for particulates. So here's the open fires that we've been talking about, showing, you know, the 100 milligrams of emissions, right down to the EcoDesign Ready stove. So this is the improvement we're showing, 90%. And again, these are the stoves of 10 years ago, which are improvement on the open fire. But this is, again, and this is the EcoDesign limit. So basically under EcoDesign, that's the level of emissions you're allowed to have. But the average that we are producing from the stoves that we're releasing today are sitting down here. So you can see the improvement that we're producing. And that's my presentation. Except to say, you know, we really believe that the EcoDesign stoves that we're launching today are part of the solution to air quality across the country. And we're making them available today rather than waiting until 2020. So I'll hand over to Neil Powers if that's okay. Thank you.
Well done. Well, thank you very much. It's great pleasure to be a co-sponsor today with Robert, because I'm very much chair of the Environment, Food and Rural Affairs Select Committee, so therefore to follow what DEFRA is doing, hold various inquiries, and it's great to have you here today. I can apologise because a lorry load of stoves arrived and we could not get them in here. My staff were sent out to try and negotiate, but you've got your posters in. I think perhaps historically we have had one or two fires in the House of Commons. Perhaps we didn't want another, but I'm sure your stoves would be absolutely safe. And what I wanted to say to you quite clearly is how much what you're doing fits into the world that we have, because we've got, you know, inquiries going on into air quality all the time. We've got problems in our inner cities with very high levels of NOx, very high levels of particulates. And so therefore anything we can do to reduce that from open fires and others through your stoves has got to be an absolute benefit. Also, of course, we want to manage our woodland better.
and there's a lot of fuel out there, a lot that could be used in a way of thinning and managing that woodland so much better, and of course creates employment, creates industry in the countryside, because you know if you're off grid, you've either got to use LPG, which usually you know you've got to pay through the nose for. Oil varies, sometimes it's up, sometimes it's down, and of course wood burners are absolutely lovely to sit by, because I don't know about how all you like it, it's lovely to sit by an open fire to see the whole of life go before you, and there's nothing like sitting next to a wood burner. And I was saying earlier that being a farmer, I don't replace things very often. You know, when the carpet's got a hole in it, it's time to replace it 20, 25 years later, and the same with the wood burner. It was about 20, 22, 23 years ago we had our old wood burner. We recently replaced it. Not only does the airflow and the gases and the emissions reduce, but the efficiency of the amount of wood, I reckon we get at least twice as much heat from the wood that we burn. And you know, there's an old adage that people's hearts are on the left and their pockets are on the right. And so therefore, I think not only should we appeal to people to have new wood burners on the fact that we are lowering the emissions, we can also say to them, you will get a great deal more heat from that wood. And of course, if you're burning less wood to get that heat, you've got less emissions anyway. And so the whole thing is very much a win-win situation. So it's great to see you here. I know one or two of you suggested from the industry that perhaps a reduction in VAT and various things. We'll have to talk to the Treasury about that, won't we, Robert? And they're always very generous, the Treasury. And I guess, of course. But no, it's good to have you all here, because I think what you show is that we link between the city, the countryside, excellent reductions in emission, and like I said, I think a very good industry around the wood burning industry generally can be built up around very efficient stoves. So it's a great pleasure to have you here this afternoon. Thank you very much.
That's it. Basically, please feel free to circulate for the next half hour or so, and thank you again for coming.
Well done. Very good. Okay.